This week marks 10 days since the Senate passage of the NMI U.S. Workforce Act of 2018. And for those of you counting down the days awaiting President Trump's signature, keep counting, and here's why.
On June 28th in Washington, D.C., June 29th here in the CNMI, the United States Senate passed the Northern Mariana Islands U.S. Workforce Act of 2018, otherwise commonly referred to as the CW Bill. And following this passage, Governor Ralph Torres's newsletter states this, quote, "The bill now heads to the White House for the president's action," end quote. As well, Governor Torres says within 10 days, the president will sign the bill. And this is said to be misleading, explains Congressman Greg Khalili-Sablon.
I knew when I read the governor's June 29 newsletter that he was mistaken. Mm-hmm. Of course, it's not my place to correct him. But he should have been more careful, because people are anxious about this whole thing. Mm-hmm. I have been getting a lot of questions also from people if the bill is law. His word is on the way to the president for signature. That is very deceiving.
As it stands, not yet at the White House. The office of the governor sits down with KSPN2 to clarify.
In an earlier release statement, we noted that the president will sign the bill within 10 days. We understood that. But as a point of clarification, the bill must be presented to the president first.
And Congressman Greg Khalili-Sablon tells us the process of how the bill moves to the president's office.
Can you explain the process of how the Workforce Act goes from the Senate to President Trump's desk?
Yes. When Congress is in session and a bill is passed by Congress, it normally takes between the average time is 5 to 9 days to enroll a bill and get it signed by the presiding officers of the House and the Senate and transmit it to the president.
The bill passed the Senate 10 minutes prior to adjournment. According to Congressman, this is important to note.
Congress was adjourned. And Congress can't do those official acts when they're adjourned. They have to be in session. Now, the first day they're in session was today.
So for those that are misled by this 10 days and believing in...
Or the governor is misled himself. Mm-hmm. He should have checked his information. I also have been getting a lot of questions from people if the bill has actually been signed into law. And I, you know, regret that it can't be signed into law, because it needs to be enrolled and signed by the presiding officers, and that can only be done when Congress is in session.
Now in session, the bill can be transmitted. As of now, the NMI U.S. Workforce Act of 2018 is still in Congress, awaiting to be enrolled, signed, and transmitted to the White House.
And after it has been presented, he has within 10 days, excluding Sundays, to act on the bill pursuant to Article 1, Section 7 of the United States Constitution.
Bautista says Governor Torres has received assurances.
At the end of the day, we've been in constant communication with both the White House and the Office of the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Paul Ryan, and we received notification from the Speaker's office that the bill will likely be transmitted to the White House this week.
So you're saying this week it'll move to the President's office?
Yes, and then that's our understanding, that it will most likely be transmitted from the Speaker's office to the White House. And then from there, once the White House Office of Legislative Affairs documents it and then receives the transmittal from the House of Representatives, the bill will then be presented to the president. And then from there, the 10-day constitutional requirement commences.